So hey, hello everyone. So this video I'm going to show you how to run your Flutter app in your Android mobile device. So currently I have here a sample project over here. It's just a simple piece of code, simple app that I have done. So first thing what you need to do is, before running a Flutter app, you need to connect your mobile phone by using a USB to your laptop or your PC. For those who don't know what is a USB is, it's just this simple cable, USB cable. So this is a cable that is used to put charge to your mobile device. So just connect it to your laptop or PC. Okay, connect your mobile phone to it. So after connecting it, what you need to do is you need to go to settings option of your mobile phone. So I have actually projected my mobile phone screen over here. So you need to go to your settings, okay? Settings option, and you need to go to developer options. Okay, developer tools or developer options, it may be called differently in some devices. Okay, so just if you have the search option over in settings of your mobile device, just search developer options. And if you don't have, it will be present in more settings as in my case, and just go to developer options. Okay, so after going to developers options, you need to on two options. One is USB debugging, just click allow, and another one option is going to be developer options itself. So just click allow also. So actually, like it will come like a dev mode, like a red notification on top of your device. So it isn't any harmful, it won't do any harm to your device, so don't worry about that. So after checking these two options, just come back to your Android Studio, and here you can see the name of your mobile device. So my phone is Vivo, so I can see the name of my mobile device over here, and you will be also seeing your device. So now if I just go to my mobile phone, and if I just uncheck both these options, okay, and again go to Android Studio, as you can see here, no device selected. So I have only the two devices, that is the Chrome web and Chrome web server. I don't have my device. And if I just do it again, and where is USB? Okay. So I will get my device working. So just want to tell you why we are doing this. So once you have selected our device, okay, just hit this run option over here, run main dot dot, just run it. So as you can see here in this run like terminal, you will be getting launching library slash main dot dot on your mobile device in debug mode until coming running get dash assemble debug. So if this is your first time that you are running your Flutter app, it will definitely take some moment of time, and this time depends upon the speed of your laptop and your speed of your mobile. In my case, both are slow, so it will take some time for me. Okay, so after some time, you will be getting this tick option and build app. Some app debug.apk, and if you don't get any red color text over here in this console, that means that your app has successfully installed on your device. And now if I just go and check on my device, I'll be getting this app name. So this is the Flutter logo, as you can see. If you haven't specified any logo, you will be getting the default logo, and you can even specify some logos, okay. And this name of the new trial, this directly corresponds to the name of the project. So as you can see here, my project name is new trial, so my app, that's the app name. Okay, so if you just open this app now, so if I just click and open it, so it's basically my simple to-do app. Okay, so your app just pops out if it runs successfully. Okay, and suppose if you have run your app and you want to stop all the process, you can just click the stop button. This just terminates your running of your app on your mobile device. So that's it. We have run successfully our Flutter app on your mobile device. So that's it for this video, and my environment tutorials in C++, Java, Flutter, also Unity, Blender, etc. So do check out other videos of my channel, and kindly subscribe and support me, and thanks for watching.